Yes, you do. ponerse de pie. Tesoro Jesús, Jesus' hands have been washed in the footprints of the stranger on Galilee's shore, and the voice that subdued the rock.
Praise the Lord, my fellow servants of Christ. Welcome to our Sunday service. Thank you so much for joining on YouTube, on Facebook, and then also on Zoom. We definitely thank you so much. And as we begin, let us go ahead and pray and open this in prayer. Heavenly Father, our Lord and Savior, mighty Jesus Christ, mighty Holy Spirit, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we come before you today that you have provided, the day that you have created, the day that you woke us up, and the day that you have given us grace to come together to worship you, to fellowship with you. Lord, we want to thank you so much for the mighty blood of Jesus. We thank you for the mighty holy cross, the old rugged cross. And we certainly thank you so much for the mighty Holy Spirit in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bring our repentance before you, my Lord. We ask you to forgive us. Forgive us our sins, my Father, starting from me. Forgive me if there's any sin, if there's any wickedness, if there's any unholiness in me, Lord, I ask you to forgive me and wash me with the mighty blood of Jesus. Clean every wrinkle, every spot, and make it as white as snow, my Lord. Father, I bring every other person before you that is connected to us today, that, Lord, you wash them with your mighty blood, as white as snow, my Lord. If there's any debt, any wrinkle, any unrighteousness in any of them, my Lord, have mercy and wash us. Because we believe that the blood of Jesus can wash away any sin, my Lord. We thank you, my Father. Father, I ask you in the mighty name of Jesus that today that you will rain down here, my Lord, that you will open heavens, that every single person that is connected, every single servant that is connected, my Lord, that you will connect their hearts into heaven, because the Messiah died for our hearts. Lord, I ask you that you fill each and every one of us with the mighty Holy Spirit. You renew us and fill us to the brim. When you fill us like Ezekiel 47, where the water goes beyond our shoulders and that we have no control but the will of God. Fill us to that brim. Not an ankle, not a knee level, not a waist level, but above the shoulder, my Lord. Oh Lord, the God of Israel, we ask you, my Father, to increase our faith, and we ask you to give us the gift of faith, Lord. We ask you to give us knowledge and understanding and the ability to be able to discern, my Lord. Father, may you unite us. May you bring us together. Lord, we know that these are the end times. And that, Father, we ask that you never leave us alone. Father, we ask that you remove any form of anxiety in us and recommit us and commit our footsteps. That on that day, the day that is unknown to man, that day we will be raptured. We will climb the steps, the holy glorious steps, the holy glorious feet into your kingdom. That, Father, you will command our footsteps to go with you, to be with you forever. We open this with the blessings of the Lord. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and amen.
Amen.
So now we'll go over to worship. And then I think we will also have the ability to play the judgment that the Lord played. I mean, the Lord came on life. And then also, I think it's a combination of judgment and also blessings. So we'll also listen to that maybe after worship. All right, thank you so much again. Back to the technical team.
Washed in the footprints of the stranger on Galilee's shore, and the voice that subdued the rough billows will be heard in Judea no more. But the path of that lone Galilean, with joy I will follow today. And the toils of the road will seem nothing when I get to
can, no one will.
It's not always easy bearing Calvary's cross. Still I love standing up for my Jesus, 'cause of all that he's done for me. That's why I am not ashamed of the gospel. The gospel of Jesus Christ. No, I am not afraid to be counted, but I'm willing to give my life. See, I'm ready to be all he wants me to be. For every moment his hand has had mercy, for all the love he's shown in my life. A simple thanks just doesn't say how I'm feeling. I get tears in my eyes. So as for me, I'm gonna keep on believing in the one who's been so faithful to me. I'm not out to please this whole world around me. Oh, I've got my mind on eternity. That's why I am not ashamed of the gospel, the gospel of Jesus Christ. No, I am not afraid to be counted, but I'm willing to give
before time. We are a vapor, you are eternal. Love everlasting, reigning on high. Redeemer, mighty to save. You are the love song we'll sing forever, bowing before you, blessing your name.
Praise the Lord, precious people. Thank you for worshiping with us. Next, we're going to play a recording that played on Jesus is Lord Radio early this morning. Thank you.
Praise the Lord, my lords, the mightiest, mightiest prophets of the Lord.
Well, blessed people, the Lord has spoken. I know that you are assembled and gathered in your churches all over this nation and all over the world. I want to bring your attention to this conversation the Lord has been having with me for the past 3 days. The Lord has been showing me the B-52 nuclear bomber of the U.S. Army, the U.S. Air Force. Again, the Lord has been showing me the B-52 nuclear bomber of the United States of America landing in South Korea.
Praise the Lord, my lords, the mightiest, mightiest prophets of the Lord.
Well, blessed people, the Lord has spoken. I know that you are assembled and gathered in your churches all over this nation and all over the world. I want to bring your attention to this conversation the Lord has been having with me for the past 3 days. The Lord has been showing me the B-52 nuclear bomber of the U.S. Army, the U.S. Air Force. Again, the Lord has been showing me the B-52 nuclear bomber of the United States of America landing in South Korea. And in that dream, the Lord showed me the soldiers that were lined up. They were taking a group photo there against the background of the aircraft. And the Lord told me, this is dreadful. By voice, he said, this is very dreadful. And then shortly after that, yesterday, you see that one of the nuclear bombers of the U.S. flew, I think it flew all the way from Missouri Air Force Base and landed in South Korea, a nuclear bomber. Now, the Lord has spoken about a nuclear war that is coming to the earth. And you know, when a nuclear war takes place on this earth, nobody will survive. It will be a total destruction and devastation of the earth. And so I have seen that Russia does use a nuclear weapon, a nuclear bomb, and strikes France first, after which strikes the UK, and then strikes Washington. That I have seen. And I've given that prophecy again and again. Those are serious prophecies that will almost bring this entire earth to an end, to bring this life to an end. Because the Lord has also come and shown me the soil in France. After the nuclear bomb, the soil is totally unusable. And actually cracks. It cracks like in your terrible drought. And the soil is totally unusable. It can be unusable for up to 200 years. And especially the nuclear weapons of this age are more lethal than what you saw the U.S. use in Hiroshima and Nagasaki. And now you see, recently Russia said that they think Ukraine is planning to use a dirty bomb inside Ukraine. And then there is a lot of fight back. The U.S., France, and Britain say, no, please, that is an excuse Russia is having to use, that it may use a nuclear bomb in Ukraine. So the world is sitting on the verge of a nuclear war, and so you need to prepare for the coming of the Messiah. The most important message there is prepare for the coming of the Messiah. Why is the Lord showing me for the past few days the nuclear bomber B-52 landing in South Korea, and the Lord saying, look, very dreadful, very, very deadly, very dreadful. So you need to prepare for the coming of the Messiah. Other than that, I want to bless you all wherever you are worshiping from. I bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. So it shall be. Amen.
Hallelujah. Welcome back again, my fellow servants. We first of all, we take the blessings of the Lord. The Lord instructed that he's blessed us. And there's no any other blessing than to bless us from the Lord. And when the Lord blesses us, it's basically a blessing that would keep us focused on the eternal gospel, that will keep us walking towards the kingdom of God and not of the world. Everything that the Lord keeps prophesizing and talking about is dreadful. So my prayer is that when that day comes, or before that day comes, the Lord will come and take us home. Because Isaiah said that, enter your rooms and shut the door. The Lord will not allow such a devastation to consume his church, his holy elect. So let us have hope, but above all, let us continue to walk in absolute holiness and righteousness and continue to seek the face of the Lord, that we will be the remnant of the remnant of the remnant, so that on that day we can be prepared. And then we know that through these blessings, there are cripples that are walking. Through these blessings, there are, you know, miracles of the Lord, you know, that are being transpired. So let us receive the blessings, even within our local areas in the United States, so that we too shall partake in the latter rain that is being poured down the earth. We'll go back to worship, and then we'll come back and call on the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Praise the Lord. Thank you for joining us for worship. Now I will call on Senior Pastor Peter John to join us to introduce the Holy Spirit for us.
Praise the Lord, my fellow servants. This is the time to call on the mighty Holy Spirit, the Spirit of the Lord, the Spirit that we worship in spirit and in truth, the Spirit of truth. And we know that it is He that goes into the heart of the Father and then comes back to report, and whatever at all He sees here is what He goes to report to the Father. So let us go ahead and then call on Him. Remember, it is He that will continue to sanctify us until we enter the kingdom of God. And it is He who will be with us forever and ever. This is how how important the mighty Holy Spirit is in our essential walk with God, the Father. He is God Himself. Let us go ahead and begin with a scripture. Let us go to John 1. The book of John 1, I think John 1. John chapter 1. Starting from verse 1. It says, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through Him, all things were made. Without Him, nothing was made that has been made. In Him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light, the true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, and to those who believe in his name, he gave right to become children of God," you and I. "Children born not of natural descent, nor human decision, or a husband, well, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth." Let us jump straight to John 15. John 15. Starting from John 15, starting from let's start from verse 1. "The vine and the branches. He says, I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does bear fruit, he prunes, so that it will be even more fruitful. You are already clean because of the words I have spoken to you. Remember in me, as I also, remain in me, as I also remain in you. No branch can bear fruit by itself. It must remain in the vine. Neither can you bear fruit unless you remain in me, unless we remain in him. Let's go to verse 18. He says, if the world hates you, keep in mind that it hated me first. If you belong to the world, it will love you as its own. As it is, you do not belong to the world. But I have chosen you out of the world. That is why the world hates you. Remember that I told you, a servant is not greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will persecute you also. If they obey my teaching, they will obey yours also. They will treat you this way because of my name. For they do not know the one who sent me. If I had not come and spoken to them, they would not be guilty of sin. But now they have no excuse for their sin. Whoever hates me hates my Father as well. Now let's jump to verse 26, still John 15. He says, when the advocate comes, whom I will send to you from the Father, the Spirit of truth, who goes out from the Father, he will testify about me. That's what I was saying earlier on. And you also must testify, for you have been with me from the beginning. Heavenly Father, mighty Holy Spirit, the Lord of creation, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Moses and Elijah, the God of Alpha, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. Lord, your Spirit came and gave birth to the Church of Christ. We those who are connected here today. Lord, we come before you with humility. We come before you with our hearts bowed down in submission to your will. And we ask you, my Father, to come in and take control, to come in and orchestrate the service according to your will, not the will of man. That, Father, that today we will take after the service, that whatever I thought that is preached, we will go back and review the scriptures for our benefits. Because your scripture said that when he spoke those words to them, they were clean. And from that, we are reading the same words to clean our spirit and to consume. But Lord, we submit the whole temple that you have built before you, my Lord, and that you will purify us, that you will guide us, that you will teach us, you will remind us. And Lord, we know that we are also in the last days. And Father, I ask with humility that any stain on our garments, my Lord, may you reveal it to us so that we can repent. That if there's anything that would prevent us from entry into your kingdom, my Lord, that today you will begin to remind us, you will begin to show it to us so that we can repent. So that on that day you will remember us. Mighty Holy Spirit, we submit this to your authority and we ask you to take over and to guide us. And that those, everybody that is connected, that Father, you touch them wherever at all they are, so that they too will be able to listen the message that you have used your servant to prepare. In the name above all names, mighty Holy Spirit, we submit our hearts for your perfect consumption. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much. Now we'll go back to worship, and then we'll come back again for the word. Thank you so much again. God bless you.
Nations will see your righteousness, and all kings your glory. And you will be called by a new name that the mouth of the Lord will bestow. You who call on the Lord, give yourselves no rest, and give him no rest, till he establishes Jerusalem and makes her the praise of all the earth.
Spirit of the Sovereign Lord, come and make your presence known, reveal the glory of the living God. Spirit of the Sovereign Lord, come and make your presence known, reveal the glory of the
I enter
enter the Holy of Holies. I enter through the blood of the Lamb. I enter to worship you only. I enter to honor I am. Lord, I worship you. I worship you. Lord, I worship you. I worship you. For your name is holy.
For your name.
Let the life of your river flow. Let the truth of your kingdom reign in us. Let the weight of glory, let the weight of your glory. Your glory
Praise the Lord, precious people. Now we'll call on Senior Pastor Peter John to give the powerful word.
Yeah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, my fellow servants of the Most High. Praise the Lord. We thank God for creating this day, giving us the opportunity to come before him, to really worship him. Today, I wanted to talk about the times that we are in. We listened to an early message when the Lord spoke to the two mega ancient prophets, talked about a nuclear war coming to the world, talked about how dreadful it will be. Basically, life will be impossible. Even talked about what the Lord took them to France and to see the soil. So you think about it, especially we, those who are the people of the way, walking the way, walking the narrow gate, walking that tight rope. Sometimes it comes with anxiety. And that is exactly the message today. The anxiety. How do we overcome the anxieties of these times whilst we stand strong, we stand strong in the Lord? Because this is not the time to quit. We have come so long. We have come so far. You know, I was looking at some pictures that I took in Kenya. It was a video, and it was showing me the Google summary photos. And I can't believe that it's been 8 years. Time has gone. Almost. So it tells you that, you know, some of you have even in this ministry, glorious ministry, even longer than that. So you look at it and see, within all these years, you have toiled, you've served the Lord, you've evangelized, you've tried to be holy and righteous. For the woman, you've even gone into holy dressing, which is contrary to the dressings in this country. And people have mocked at you. People have looked at you different. People have even called you that you are a Quaker. And yet, you have not given up. You stood with the Lord. So I wanted to use this opportunity that these times that we are in, this is the time you need to hold on to what you have. This is the time you actually even need to embrace the Lord more, because the Lord can overcome everything. The Lord can overcome. The Lord surely can overcome. I want to first of all just start basically with our target scripture or the scripture of the day, and then we'll go ahead and anchor everything. Let's look at Isaiah 26. Let's start from verse 19. The target scripture is verse 20, but let's start from verse 19. Isaiah 26. He said, "But your dead will live. Lord, their bodies will rise. Let those who dwell in the dust wake up and shout for joy. Your dew is like the dew of the morning. The earth will give birth to her dead." Verse 20, he says, "Go, my people, enter your rooms and shut the doors behind you. Hide yourselves for a little while until his wrath has passed by." He went ahead to say in verse 21, but the target is verse 20. He says, "See, the Lord is coming out of his dwelling to punish the people of the earth for their sins. The earth will disclose the bloodshed on it. The earth will conceal its slain no longer." You know, right now, we are all enjoying the mercies of the Lord, whether you are a believer or not a believer, whether you are part of the five wise virgins or the five wicked virgins. We are all enjoying because the sun has shined on each and every one. When the rain falls, it falls on the wicked land. The wicked and on their land, and then the righteous. But a time is coming soon, very soon, quickly soon, where the Lord will now separate his holy elect from the chaff and take them. And that is what the target scripture is saying in Isaiah 26, verse 20. "Go, my people, enter your rooms and shut the doors behind you. Hide yourself for a while or for a little while until his wrath has passed away." This is a promise of the Lord that he will hide you until his wrath has passed away. And that is why the topic or the theme today is anxiety, referencing the scripture. So let us start with Philippians. Philippians 4, starting from verse 6, and we'll end at verse 8. So Philippians 4. Starting from verse 6, he said, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God." My brothers and sisters, the nuclear war is coming. The Lord has spoken. What can we do as believers? We pray. We present our petition, our thanksgiving, our request before the Lord. The request that the Lord will save us. The request that the Lord will say, "Enter your room and shut the doors behind you until his wrath has passed." Verse 7, he said, "And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus." Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. Whatever is true, the true is the Spirit of God. The true is that Jesus Christ died for you and I. The truth is that he was buried for 3 days. On the third day, The truth is that he resurrected. The truth is that he ascended into heaven. The truth is that he is now sitting on the right-hand side of the Father, interceding for you and I. So times like this, when you are anxious, go ahead and ask the Lord, our Father. Ask Jesus Christ, the Son of God, to intercede for you. And he will, because this is the promise. He said, what is noble, what is right, whatever is pure, ask for the holiness, ask for the righteousness of God. Whatever is admirable, the admiration is that Jesus Christ is now sitting on the right-hand side of the Father, that he lives, that this is not a God that is there. This is not an idol God. This is not a God that when you speak to, he doesn't speak back to you. That is admirable. This is the only religion that gives you that. You know, there's no Hindu or Islamic God that can speak back to you. And I can tell you on first hand, because I used to be a Muslim. And no, in any case, did that God ever spoke to me. It was only spoken that on that day, your deeds will be weighed, the good or the bad. And whichever at all, that is weighs much, that particular deed is the one that will be put away. That if you are on the right-hand side, you know, you go to heaven or paradise, and the vice versa. That is the only thing they spoke of. They talk about the rhymes of the Quran, but I'm here to tell you that the God that created heaven and earth, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, that he lives, he speaks to us, he talks to us, he is in us. And now you can even see through the servants of the Lord, the power, because this is the God whose blood has healed HIV, even though the medical journal, the best scientists, the best hospitals cannot even treat it. This is the time that we all need to remember that we are so blessed and honored that the Lord has given us. He sent us Jesus Christ, who died for us, who died for each and every one of us, so that we can enjoy, or we can enter into his righteousness through the blood. We can enter into his holiness through the blood. Let us go to Matthew 6. Matthew 6, starting from verse 31. Matthew 6, starting from verse 31 through 34. Do not worry, saying, what shall we eat? Or what shall we drink? Or what shall we wear? For the pagans run after all those things, and your heavenly Father knows what you need. But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself. Each day has enough trouble on its own. You know, so why should you be anxious? Can you add a single day to your life? Why should you be anxious? You know, your Heavenly Father knows your needs. And remember, the Bible is talking about needs. Not once. You know, if I think about the world, you could say, oh, I want the most beautiful house. I want the most, you know, beautiful car. I want this. I want this. I want this. But the Lord looks at your needs. What do you need to survive and to worship him and to fellowship with him? That is what you need. So he says, do not worry about all these things. What you should do, and this is the God of the Most High, the Holy God of Israel. This is the God that is even teaching us. If we go to pray, how we need to pray. If we go to seek him, this is how we seek him. He said, but seek first the kingdom and his righteousness. So my brothers and sisters, when you go into your closet, this is what you are to do. Seek the kingdom of God and the righteousness of the Messiah, the holiness of the Messiah. And if you do that, this is a promise that everything else, the Lord will take care of it. Because the Lord knows that this is a temporal place. Remember, we were chosen out of this world, and that the world will hate us because we no longer look like the world. Let us look at Psalm 56. Psalm 56, verse 3. The book of Psalms. We're going to be going through Psalms today. The book of Psalms, verse 56. 5-6. The book of Psalms, 56, verse 3. 56, verse 3. When I am afraid, I put my trust in you. Do not be anxious. Your anxiety, cast it onto the cross. Cast it onto the Lord. Because the Lord knows that when this trial times comes, he will take you away. Enter your rooms or enter your chambers and shut the door until the wrath of God has passed. See, that is the target scripture we talked about, Isaiah 26, verse 20. The anxiety, the worriness, there's so much trouble in the world. Do not worry about anything. Just seek the kingdom of God. And as you seek the kingdom of God, seek the righteousness of that kingdom. And who created it is Christ Jesus. Seek him. And he said, he will be there. He will cast those anxieties away. Let us look at Matthew 6, verse 27. Matthew 6, verse 27. Matthew 6, verse 27. Can any of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your life? This is powerful. Can any of us, with all the anxieties, add a single hour, not a day, to our lives? That means we don't have control over it. Who has the control? Who created you? It's Christ Jesus. So we need to cast it onto the cross. We need to hand it over into the hands of God. And then let the Lord decide. And if you hand it over and you seek the righteousness, the kingdom and its righteousness, then the Lord will take all these anxieties away from you. Psalm 94. So let us go, let's look at Matthew before we come to Psalm 94. Matthew 11, because whilst we are still in Matthew. Matthew 11, starting from verse 28. Matthew 11, starting from verse 28 through 30. He said, come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, but you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light. Wow. So whatever anxiety, all the judgments that is coming, the Lord, those judgments are intended for the rebellious. But you have a way. You have been given a way. That's why they call you, the Bible calls us, the people of the way of the Lord, the way of holiness, the way of righteousness. That for us, we know him. The world does not know him, but we know him. So he says, we should come come to him. He said, come to me, all you who are weary and burdened, and I'll give you rest. Wow. So whatever anxiety that you have, give it unto the Lord. Whatever worry that you have, you know, we are still almost getting away of pre-pandemic, even though it's still sometimes deadly out there. But we know that there are still different pestilences, diseases that are still coming, and that we should cast that onto him, and he will guide us. We will find rest in him. He said his yoke is easy and the burden is light. Let us go to Psalm 94 now, verse 19. Psalm 94, verse 19. Verse 19, Psalm 94, verse 19. He said, when anxiety was great within me, your consolation brought me joy. You see, his yoke, the burden is light. The yoke is light. Come to him. All those who are weary and burdened, come to him. Seek his kingdom and his righteousness, and everything else shall be given to you. Your heavenly Father knows your needs. Your heavenly Father knows your needs. Let us look at whilst we're in Psalm, let's look at Psalms 121. Psalms, the book of Psalms 121. 121, starting from verse 1 through 2. I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? It comes from the Lord, the creator of heaven and earth. Verse 2, he said, my help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. I actually didn't see this. This is the power of the Spirit, the Spirit of the Lord. Yes, he said, my help, because I asked the question. He said, I lift up my eyes to the mountain. Where does my help come from? And I said, from the creator of heaven and earth. And verse 2 said, my help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. This is what we talk about when the Spirit of the Lord is in the house of the Lord. He goes ahead of you. He puts the words in you. He tells you what to say. He takes over the Ezekiel 47. When the water is above your shoulder, where you have no control, and the control is left unto the Lord. That is why we need to seek the kingdom first and the righteousness of that kingdom. And the righteousness of that kingdom dwells in holiness and in righteousness. Hallelujah. Let us go to Matthew 6. Matthew 6. Matthew 6. Matthew chapter 6, starting from verse 26 through 28. Starting from verse 6. Starting from verse 26 through 28. He said, look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much valuable than they? Can any one of you, by worrying, add a single hour to your life? And why do you worry about clothes? See how the flowers of the field grow. They do not labor or spin. They do not labor or spin. This is the beauty of the God we worship. He says, do not worry. He said, cast your yoke unto him, your burden unto him. He said, his yoke is light. And then you will have rest in your souls. This is the power of the God that we worship. The God, the living God, the God most high, the God who is alive, the only God who created heavens and earth. Psalm 34, the book of Psalm 34. I told you we're going to be in Psalm and Matthew, right? The book of Psalm 34, verse 4. And what does it say? I sought the Lord, and he answered me. He delivered me from all my fears. I sought the Lord. See? You have to seek the Lord. Seek his kingdom first. I sought the Lord and he answered me. If you seek the kingdom with all your heart, it's a promise the Lord will surely answer you. He delivered me from all my fears. So whatever anxiety you have today, give it to the Lord. Seek the face of the Lord. And the Lord will deliver you from all the fears, from all the pending nuclear war that is coming, from the earthquake that has been prophesied, that the Lord knows where you are and the Lord will take care of you. The Lord will separate you. All you have to do is seek him with all your heart and your mind. Psalm 23, verse 4. Psalm 23, verse 4, he said, even though I walk through the darkest valley, I will fear no evil. For you are with me, your rod and your staff, they comfort me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. The Lord is telling you, he has power. He's the creator of heaven and earth. And everything that dwells in it is under his palm. He has the power. And that you should not worry. That's why we, the people of the way, we don't worry. When things are happening, we don't look at what we see, the physical things that we see. But we look at what is spiritual, what the Lord talks about. We stand with the Lord, the word of the Lord, because the word of the Lord is the one that we need to stand and anchor on. That is why each and every one of us at any given point in time, we need to embed ourselves in this word. When we are worried, we need to embody ourselves in the word. When we are given thanksgiving, we need to embody ourselves in the word. The word is everything. In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word becomes flesh through him that we now worship. And we have peace. And it is him who said that his burden is light. His yoke is not so much of a burden. And that whoever at all that casts his or her burden on him, you will have rest. Your soul will have rest. Hallelujah. Let us go to Isaiah 41. Isaiah 41. Isaiah 41, verse 10. Isaiah 41, verse 10. He said, so do not fear. I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. So for us, when they throw something at you, like I said, or like the Spirit of the Lord was talking through me last week, he said, the devil is just a nuisance. He's on your way. All you have to do is move him and he will go if you insist, because the word, the power has been given to you and not him and not to the darkest world. It's the light is given to you so that through you, the dark world may be able to see the light. You need to shine through that. And that is what he's saying here. You do not have to fear. He is there with you. Proverbs. Proverbs 12, verse 25. Proverbs 12, verse 25. Anxiety weighs down the heart, but a kind word cheers it up. anxiety weighs down the heart, but the kind words cheers it up. So if you are anxious today, if you have any anxiety today, remember the words that has been given to you, the power of the gospel of Christ, the power and the strength and the authority of our Lord Jesus Christ, that he has overcome the world, and that through him you have peace, and that you're not worry of the troubles in this world. You cannot even add an hour to your life. Why worry about it? Just cast the burden, your burden on him, and you will find rest. Proverbs 17, whilst we are still in Proverbs, Proverbs 17, verse 22. He said, a cheerful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up the bones. A cheerful heart is good medicine, but a crushed spirit dries up bones. So pick up a phone, call your brothers and sisters. You know, when you call them, do not gossip. Talk about the word. Talk about what the Lord has built for you, has done for you, has installed upon for you. Share good practices of evangelism, what works for you and what hasn't worked for you, so that we can learn from one another, and together we can become powerful in Christ. Remember, we are just the arms and legs of the Lord, through which the Spirit enables us to do his good works. Hallelujah. Hebrews 13, verse 6. Hebrews 13, verse 6. Hebrews 13, verse 6. He said, so we say with confidence, the Lord is my helper. I will not be afraid. What can mere mortals do to me? Wow. The Lord is my helper. I will not be afraid. What can a mere mortal do to you? That's why when Paul was on the chopping block, he was confident. He said, you cannot destroy my soul. You can just destroy this body. You see, he said, destroy this temple and I will rebuild it in 3 days. God, he has the power. So to you, my fellow servants, the same thing, do not have anxiety. Do not let the anxiety of the world make you lose faith. Hold on to what you have, for the day will come when the Lord knows that you can no longer in this particular flesh hold on to what of the wrath is coming. And on that day, he said, enter your rooms, enter your chambers, and shut the door until his wrath has passed away. 2 Corinthians 4, verse 17. 2 Corinthians 4, verse 17. He said, for our light and our momentary troubles are achieving for us an eternal glory that far outweighs them all. And then verse 18 says, so we fix our eyes not on what is seen, but on what is unseen. Since what is seen is temporary, but what is unseen is eternally. See, when Paul was on it, he said, this is temporal. What you're going to do, you're going to kill me. You can only kill this body, but you cannot destroy this soul. You cannot destroy that. It is eternal. He said, that is eternal. That's what the unbelievers could not see. And today, you will be treated the same way, because it's a promise. Christ said, I took you, I separated you out from the world. So the world, because the world did not know me, they will not know you. They will hate you. But still, you still have to you still have to emit the light of Christ to the world, because he came and died for all. He came and sacrificed for all. And anyone who seeks him genuinely, his heart, diligently, that he will be answered. He shall answer them. Revelation 21. Revelation 21, verse 4. Revelation 21, verse 4. And this is the beauty of steadfastness. This is the beauty of walking the way. This is the beauty of not giving up. This is the beauty of the troubles that we are going through. He said, he will wipe every tear from your eyes. There will be no death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away. He who was seated on the throne said, I am making everything new. Then he said, write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true. These words are trustworthy and true. So everything that we have talked about, we took it. The Spirit of the Lord led from this book, the Word of God. And that is intended. I'm not sure why the Lord chose that. But yes, times that we've talked about anxiety, the times are hard. There's inflation out there, over 9-10% inflation. I mean, what is calculated is actually 9-10%. The real inflation in itself may be up to 15%. If you were buying eggs, the price of eggs have gone up over 300%. Energy bills are soaring up with this winter coming. Gas prices are going up. If you are the provider of the family, then you begin to worry. You begin to say, how can I make it? Because the only factor that has not changed in that equation is your salary or your pay, your wages. It still stays the same. And then you are worried. What am I going to eat? What are my children going to eat? Do I even have savings anymore? How am I going to pay my mortgage and still eat? How am I going to pay my electricity bill? When a child is sick, how am I going to take care of? And so on and so forth. It gives you anxiety. It gives you depression. If you are retired, you're thinking about, you're looking at your savings, everything that you save going down. And what is coming in cannot hold value. And then you ask yourself, if this happens for another 10 years, I will be wiped out. How am I going to save? How am I going to survive? This message is for you. This message is here. And maybe the Lord chose it for this reason, that as we go along, when times get harder, go back to this particular sermon that is stored on YouTube, the anxiety that we go through. And remember the target scripture, which is Isaiah 26, verse 20, that these things are temporal, that the Lord on that day, when you cannot bear anymore, when you have overcome, the Lord said, he would say, enter your chamber, enter your rooms and shut the door behind you. It's the Lord himself who shuts the door. And then his wrath comes over the rebellious, the unrepentant hearts of this current generation. I'm here today to give you hope. And that hope is that the Messiah is coming and that our worry, our anxieties is short-lived and that we shall overcome. But we cannot do it without the blood. We cannot overcome without the power of the heavenly realms, the power of the coming age. But if we give everything and cast everything into him, we shall overcome.
we shall be able to do it. And that is why this last scripture is saying that after all these suffering, after all these anxiety, after all these difficulties, after all these thinking about how am I going to eat, how am I going to survive, how am I going to pay my bills, and so on, he said, he will wipe every tears from your eyes, and there will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away. Let us be holy. Let us be righteous. Let us seek the righteousness of the Messiah, the righteousness and the holiness of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. For those who would like to receive the Lord, this is the right time, because time is over. Because on that day, it's going to be one and only 10, those who will have the marker of the blood of the Messiah. Those whose hearts will be filled with the blood, those are the people that will be taken up. Because when your heart is filled with the blood, the righteousness of the Messiah is in you and his holiness is in you. So for those of you who would like to receive the Lord, let us take this opportunity and receive the Lord. And then you could repeat this after me. Say, dear God, we come before you today and we ask you, my Lord, to forgive us of our sins, known and unknown. That mighty Jehovah, we have nowhere to go but to come to you. And we ask that the righteousness of the Messiah, that we enter into the righteousness of the Messiah, the holiness of the Messiah. Father, we ask you to forgive us our sins, all our sins, known and unknown, and wash us with your precious blood. Father, remember us on that day. And that on that day, let the scripture of Isaiah 26, verse 20, that everyone that is tuned in today, my Lord, that let that scripture be fulfilled in them, in the mighty name of Jesus. That Father, write and keep our names in the Lamb's book of life in heaven. Today, we give ourselves to you. We surrender everything into your well-able hands. And we say thank you. And we thank you so much for, because today we are born again in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. If you have repeated this particular prayer, this is an opportunity for you to get baptized. I know it's getting cold, but when the Messiah is coming, you know, you could get baptized in an indoor pool. And I ask each and every one of you, for those of you joining us, please, not every church is a church. And I get it, you know, that when you are in the world and then you come, you may mistaken and think that every church is a church. You could go and sit in the inner sermon out there, outside the ministry of repentance. And then you would hear, you'll be surprised to hear that holiness is being trumpeted. Righteousness is being trumpeted. You will be surprised to hear that everything that is being trumpeted is about the kingdom of God. But here in the ministry of the Lord, that is what you will hear, because that is the eternal gospel. Fear God and give him glory. That seek his righteousness. That is the eternal gospel. The eternal gospel is seek the kingdom of God first and its righteousness. No other place. The other places will tell you about how to prosper here on earth, as if you are going to live here forever. They will tell you, at those places, they can never tell you they are healed. They can never even tell you how many cripples are healed, how many HIV, how many cancers, how many deaf ears, how many blind eyes are open. They can't show you that. Here in the ministry of repentance and holiness, you have that. And then you take it to yourself and see if
The miracles of the Bible are happening right now here in this ministry. And you go out there and you don't see that, you be the judge. You know where God is. I want to leave that, and I thank you so much. And I will hand it over to our technical team so that they can go ahead and, you know, go back to worship. But thank you so much again for joining us today for this powerful sermon. We bless you in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Sought the Lord, and He answered me and delivered me from every fear. Those who look on Him are radiant, they'll never be ashamed, they'll never be ashamed. This Corbin cried, and the Lord heard me and saved me from my enemies. The Son of God surrounds His saints. He will deliver them. He will deliver them.
Hallelujah, blessed people. Thank you all for coming. And this concludes our Sunday service for today. So amen. We bless the name of the Lord. And we pray that you all have a blessed day, rest of your day. Amen. Shalom.